Hi guys, I'm Abhishek and you're watching Solo Gaming. So we are at the capital outskirts. This video is from one of my first excursions in this region, and earlier I had skipped this area by breezing through it on Torrent to reach the draconic tree sentinel at the capital's back entrance. The whole ambience of this place is majestic, and the non-boss encounter we are going to have is as appropriate to it. The golems guarding the way to the back entrance of the capital first make their presence known when you hear the missile-like swooshing of arrows that they fire and the loud thud it creates on the ground. Of the three of them, two are ranged enemies and one is a melee golem. The melee golem has protection at the ankles of his feet, where the other two are vulnerable. The reverse fire breathing and rock slinging with their weapon was a surprise move for me, and it got me twice before I found the footage for this video. What made this whole encounter special for me was the whole setting of the area, the way these golems were positioned and how dynamically they acted than the ones found in the early regions of the game. Now, my personal hard and tiring favorite encounter was with the melee golem among the three. There are a couple of reasons for it. First, I mostly went on foot for him. Second, I was trying to hit his weak spots on his wrists, which I couldn't, but still kept at it, and the fight dragged on, turning it into a full-fledged battle between a giant and a tarnished. Third reason was that this guy did more moves than I expected. The whole fight was just exciting. Did it give me any reward? Nothing really, except for the thrill of fighting it. Elden Ring is a game which is all about its combat, and you don't necessarily have to do any progress if you're just having a good time fighting in it. This fight was all about it. Another thing, I was really digging my character's outfit here. He looked like a hardened rogue warrior who has plenty of experience dealing with massive threats 4 times, 8 times his size, and he can go head on with anything that comes his way. My own skills had developed quite well until then. Dodging had become second nature, all the delayed attacks were easily handled, and most opportunities to hit were registered. The fight sure went on for more time than I had anticipated, but then this was my complete session that day. I just plugged in, fought these dudes and switched off, nothing more. I figured if I took them seriously and fought them properly, I can just have a good time without really doing anything in the game. And a good time this fight delivered. Two of my favorite animations from this fight are the way my character takes a blow on his great shield, the whole sliding back, standing ground, and brace for impact stance looks amazing. Also, because the shield is so big, it in a way looks plausible too. The second animation is when the golem goes away running, plowing through the land with his axe and hurling back big rocks towards us. It just looks epic. To be honest, this fight wasn't particularly challenging, but it was a fun non-boss encounter. One thing that made this fight so long is the protection this guy had on his ankles. Otherwise, he would have been taken care of just like his ranged counterparts earlier. I hope you enjoy this fight. Let me know which amazing non-boss encounter remains in your memory and one that you would recommend me to try. I'm gonna make more such videos as I find interesting moments with regular enemies, and I hope you keep coming back to enjoy them. For that, please subscribe and stay in touch with Solo Gaming. Having said that, I hope you have a good time watching this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video.